Emma smiled and chatted as cheerfully as she could to keep him from such thoughts, but when tea came, it was impossible for him not to say exactly as he had said at dinner, "Poor Miss Taylor, I wish she were here again. What a pity it is that Mr. Weston ever thought of her."
"I cannot agree with you, Papa, you know I cannot. Mr. Weston is such a good-humored, pleasant, excellent man, that he thoroughly deserves a good wife, and you would not have had Miss Taylor live with us forever, and bear all my odd humors, when she might have a house of her own?"
"A house of her own, but where is the advantage of a house of her own? This is three times as large, and you have never any odd humors, my dear. How often we shall be going to see them, and they coming to see us, we shall be always meeting. We must begin, we must go and pay wedding visit very soon.
My dear, how am I to get so far?
Randall's is such a distance.
I could not walk half so far."
"No, Papa, nobody thought of your walking.
We must go in the carriage, to be sure."
"The carriage. But James will not like to put the horses to for such a little way, and where are the poor horses to be while we are paying our visit?"
"They are to be put into Mr. Weston's stable, Papa.
You know we have settled all that already.
We talked it all over with Mr. Weston last night.
And as for James, you may be very sure he will always like going to Randall's, because of his daughter's being housemaid there.
I only doubt whether he will ever take us anywhere else."
"That was your doing, Papa.
You got Hannah that good place.